Sometimes, one mutation in one gene can cause a disease, but this is rare.
In the vast majority of common diseases, thousands of tiny changes to DNA, called genetic variants, affect a person's risk for certain diseases.
Now that scientists have uncovered these thousands of variants, we need to figure out how they work, the genes they affect, and the specific cells they act in. We call it the Variant to Function Initiative, or V2F. Scientists at the Broad are collecting and sharing massive amounts of information across thousands of variants and exploring how these variants affect six specific diseases.
Coronary artery disease, type 2 diabetes, schizophrenia,
inflammatory bowel disease, atrial fibrillation, and Alzheimer's.
For example, researchers have already discovered more than 250 variants that affect risk for inflammatory bowel disease, and more than 200 variants that affect risk for schizophrenia.
And by carefully dissecting these variants, we hope to uncover the biological mechanisms that cause these diseases and point the way to potential treatments.
Think of these variants as tiny dials that control how genes are turned on and off. Each dial in and of itself has a small effect, but together, the effect of many variants can have an enormous impact on a person's health.
One reason that this effort is such a challenge is that many of these variations are found in parts of the genome that don't code for proteins.
For these so-called non-coding regions of the genome, we still don't know the rules by which they function. Many of our traditional tools just aren't as effective.
This means that to discover the biological functions of these variants, we need a whole new way of thinking.
Researchers here at the Broad and throughout the scientific community have now made tremendous advances in technology, in ways to map all of the various cell types in the human body, methods to measure how variants affect genes in particular cell types, and in computational methods to analyze all of these variants and cell types at once.
As we begin to connect the dots between these genetic variants
and the biological mechanisms of these common diseases,
we'll be able to design drugs to target these processes and treat disease.